Well, new research suggests even short bursts of intense exercise can help us all lose weight. Dr. Maria Palafox with the Previty Clinic is here to explain how it all works. And I guess we're talking like interval training type stuff. I mean, this is what we've heard in the gyms that is could be even better for you than these long, prolonged, you know, hour, 2 hour workouts.
Right. The theory behind it is that you can, if you have short bursts of really increased intensity, I'm talking like huffing and puffing for shorter intervals, maybe 15 minutes, that you can derive a lot of benefit, very similar to, let's say you're running or maybe power walking,
right,
where you're not huffing and puffing, but you it takes longer, if you see what I'm saying.
Sure.
And I bet we've all been there. Like, I mean, I can jog on the treadmill for 30 minutes. You know, I kind of do like a 12-minute mile, and really it's no problem. And then I try to, you know, do CrossFit for 20 minutes, and it kills me.
Sure.
Or I do this extremely painful stair climber at the gym, and I almost
die. That's Jeff's favorite. Yeah, he loves
that. I mean,
that
I almost die, it's but it's because the intensity is different.
Right.
And so if you change up the intensity, you can derive a lot of benefit. I would argue that you can't exercise for just 1 minute, as the article that we reviewed talks about, but you can derive some benefit. Taking the stairs versus walking.
Sure.
Walking into the fast food restaurant as opposed to
the
driving
through.
I mean, all of that stuff really matters.
Right.
I read an interesting article a long time ago that said even the change that we have overall in our lifestyle, like using the remote control, we don't really, you know, we drive around for a parking space instead
the closest
of walking.
One. Yeah.
You know, all of that stuff over time leads us to burn less calories, and that stuff adds up. You know, they said just from using the remote control, over the course of our lifetime, we're going to gain 2 pounds.
Oh, wow.
Well, if you add, exactly.
Yeah, that, I mean, that's
2 crazy.
2 pounds
from using the remote control.
Yeah.
If you add that up to, if you add that up with all of the other things that you're doing to gain weight, it matters.
Sure. We should emphasize, we're not encouraging you to shorten your workout. I mean, as you said, these are very intense. It's like if you're going to the track and maybe walking or jogging a lap as opposed to running sprints. I mean, it's that drastic a change in the intensity.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
So,
but if you're a walker, why not run, you know, from here to the light post?
Exactly.
You know, you're right. I mean, I don't break out into an all-out run. But if you just run maybe one house down, I mean, that really has a lot of benefit compared to just walking your entire route. You'd be pleasantly surprised.
Yeah, I was working out with my son over the summer, and we'd go to the track, and I would have him walk the curves and sprint the straightaways. I mean, it's that kind of intensity that really pays off. And it's also, it doesn't just have to be in the gym, right? It can be at the track. It could even be at home if you can find something that raises that intensity level.
Right.
Yeah.
My husband and I foolishly spent money on on this insanity workout.
Oh, yeah.
And it's the theory behind that, too. It's kind of interval training, but it's relatively short, and it's the same theory.
Right.
And we didn't have to buy any equipment for it. And it just, you know, kills you for 30-second intervals, and then you rest. And then you do this 30-second interval of this ridiculous, you know, my heart rate's up to 200 or something. Not really. But you see what I'm saying. You do get a lot of benefit from it. And it is difficult. And I thought that I would be in great shape after running a half marathon, and I was. The insanity workout was easier, but it certainly wasn't a walk in the park.
So most definitely. Yeah, and with any exercise program, whether it's the high intensity, whether it's a more spread out, slower workout, we obviously talk to your doctor first, make sure you get yourself on the right plan, right?
Right.
Yeah, that's the key.
Right. The bottom line is you have to burn it more than you take in.
And that is the key. And you can't just, you have to put the diet along with that.
So. Right.
All right, there you go. Talk to your doctor, see what works best for you, and we'd like to hear from you. Let us know if you're changing your exercise plan and how it's working out for you. Doctor, good to see you.
Thank you.
Thanks for the great information. Let's get a check now of your weather forecast with meteorologist David Walter.